Geometry Unit Section 1, Angles, Part 2. Complementary angles are angles that add up to be 90 degrees. In this diagram, we have angle ABD plus angle DBC, both acute angles, combined to equal this 90 degree angle. From that, if we're given that angle DBC is 28 degrees, we can substitute that in our formula or our equation here and solve for the other component of this 90 degree angle. What, plus 28 equals 90? We'll subtract 90 from 28 to give us the measure of the acute angle ABD having a measure of 62 degrees. Supplemental angles are angles that add up to be 180 degrees. In this diagram, we have our straight angle, which if you remember is equal to 180 degrees, is broken up into two parts with this line BD. Each of these two angles that are formed add up to equal the 180 degrees. If we're given the measure of the acute angle, which is 51 degrees, we can use that information to solve for the obtuse angle in this supplementary angle configuration. Replacing the acute angle measurement into the equation, subtracting 51 from each side, resulting in 180 minus 51 degrees, gives us a measure of the obtuse angle of 129 degrees. Here they're asking us to determine the missing angles. In this diagram, we have an acute angle with a measure of 53 degrees. They're asking us to find the measure of this other acute angle and this obtuse angle indicated by the arrows here, angle Y. Well, to start off, we're going to solve for X. The acute angle, which has a measure of 53 plus X, are complementary angles, indicated here with the yellow lines. That means they add up to be 90 degrees, and solving for the missing angle, angle X, will subtract 53 from 90 to give us a measure of 37 degrees. Once we know the measure of angle X, if you look at angle X and angle Y, this obtuse angle, those two combine to give us supplementary angles. X plus Y equals 180. Replacing X with the value that we found its measurement, 37 degrees, subtract 37 from each side, leaves us with a result of 180 minus 37, or angle Y, having a measure of 143 degrees. When two lines intersect as shown, vertical angles are created. There are four angles here, and angles that are across from one another are equal. In this diagram, we have vertical angles, the two lines intersecting. We have one angle which is identified, 115 degrees. The angle across from this known measurement is angle Y. Since it's across, it has the same measurement. And to determine the measure of X and Z, which are across from one another and equal in this vertical angle diagram, we're going to use the fact that angle X and angle Y are forming supplementary angles. Those two angles are adding up to equal our straight angle, or 180 degrees. Angle X plus 115 equals 180 because of the supplementary angle relationship. Subtracting 115 from each side leaves us with X having a measure of 65 degrees, and angles across from one another are equal, so that third unknown angle also has a measure of 65 degrees. Parallel lines are straight lines that are the same distance apart. This diagram shows that lines L and M are parallel to one another. When two parallel lines are crossed by a third line called a transversal, there are eight angles formed, four here and four down here. At the top, we have vertical angles, and we know from the previous slide that angles opposite from one another have equal measurement. And furthermore, here we have angles that mathematicians call corresponding angles, which are angles that are in the same relative position. They're both to the left of the transversal and above the parallel line, to the left and above, and are equal to one another. We refer to these as corresponding angles. Here's another example of corresponding angles. This angle is to the right of the transversal and above the parallel line, as is this angle in the lower half. It's to the right and above the second parallel line. These would be examples of corresponding angles which have equal measurement. We see examples of parallel lines with a third line cutting them in many applications here in construction, as well as in a welding application where we have parallel lines using the edge as our transversal. We have corresponding angles, and from corresponding angles, we can also find relationships of equal angles with vertical angle relationships as well. Let's take a look at an example. Parallel lines L and M are cut by a third line, the transversal T. We know this obtuse angle has a measure of 118 degrees. Its corresponding angle in the same position would also have 118 degrees. The vertical angle to the given angle has 118 degrees, as does the vertical angle here, or it corresponds, it's in the same position, they're both to the right of the transversal and above the parallel line. Knowing that two angles that add up to equal a straight line is equal to 180 degrees, we can find the measure of this acute angle by taking 180 degrees minus 118 to give us that measurement of the unknown acute angle. Filling in the rest of the acute angles by corresponding angles up here, this is would be 62, and the relationship of vertical angles will give us the measure of the other missing angles. If you recall, there are 360 degrees in a circle. Knowing that fact allows one to determine the size of angles drawn inside a circle. All of the angles we will be working with have their vertex at the center of the circle. If the vertex is somewhere else, different rules apply, but we're not going to get into that right now. This slide is asking us to determine the measure of angle X. So using the fact that a circle has 360 degrees, we will take 360 minus the rotation measurement known, 240 degrees, to give us the remaining rotation or measure of this angle, which is 120 degrees. Here's another example asking us to determine the measurement of angle X. We have an angle indicated here having a measure of 13 degrees, a second angle of 48 degrees. These combine with this region indicated in the yellow for the entire angle X. Since this is half a circle, 360 divided by 2 has a measurement of 180. We will add that to the two known angles for a total measurement for angle X of 241 degrees. For many purposes, a simple plastic protractor is a good way to measure angles. Given an angle, we can measure by placing the bottom center of the protractor on the vertex. Protractors have numbers from right to left, depending on where you're starting, or they can have them left to right. We'll use the left to right here, starting with a small measurement and reading up. The estimation is it is an acute angle, so it makes sense to use these smaller numbers going from left to right. And then reading the scale on the outer edge. We can also use a protractor to draw an angle to. First, we want to draw a straight line, then make a tick mark where you want the vertex. Place the protractor over the line and make sure the center bottom portion of the protractor matches up with the tick mark. Locate the size of the angle you want to draw on the outer edge and make a small tick mark there. To finish, connect the tick mark on the original horizontal line with the tick mark that establishes the size of the angle. For practice on these concepts, turn to pages 11 through 14.